Okay, well, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. Okay, before of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Rizka Bella Dinda Rosita. My ID number T2019-60-52. Actually, I come from English Education Department of UINHAS Jember. In this opportunity, I wanna explain four theory from translation and interpreting book. The first is from Roman Jakobson theory, the second is Nidas theory, the third is Newmark theory, and the last is Kuller theory. Okay, the first is from Roman Jakobson theory. Roman Jakobson theory describe three kinds of translation. The first is intralingual, the second is interlingual, and the last is intersemiotic. Okay, the first is intralingual translation. Intralingual translation is a translate carried out in the same language. This translation into a language, namely by recommunicating a meaning with a different text in the same language. I mean, for example, an Indonesian text that is less familiar is retranslated with a more general use of words. And the second is interlingual translation. Interlingual translation is the transfer of language from a source language to a target language, from or SL to TL, source language to target language. This translation transfer the text as a whole into another language, both meaning and form. This intralingual translation is what we know as general translation. For example, translation from English to Indonesian, translation from Javanese to Indonesian, and so on. And the third is intersemiotic translation. Intersemiotic translation is an act of language transfer from verbal language to non-verbal written language. This translation is easily found in the subtitle of the film. For example, the course in the film speak English while the subtitle are in Indonesian. This is a translation from verbal to non-verbal language. Based on the explanation above, it can be concluded the translation is not only applied to transfer language to different languages, but can be applied to the same language. Even the transfer from verbal language to the written language is also called translation. Okay, the second is the nature of the meaning from Nida. When it comes to analyzing individual words, Nida describes various scientific approaches to meaning related to work that had been carried out by theorists in semantic and pragmatic. Central to Nida's work is the move away from the old idea that a word has a fixed meaning and toward a functional definition of meaning in which a word acquires meaning through its context and can produce varying responses according to culture. Meaning is broken down. Meaning is broken down into the following. Okay, the first is linguistic meaning, the second is referential meaning, the third is emotive or connotative meaning. Okay, the first is linguistic meaning. Linguistic meaning, the relationship between different linguistic structures. Nida provides example to show how the meaning crucially differs even where similar classes of words are used. For instance, the following three expressions with the possessive pronoun his call have different meaning. For example, his house means his possesses a house, and his journey equals his he performs a journey, and his kindness is kindness is quality of him, like that my mean. And the second is referential meaning. Referential meaning, the denotative dictionary meaning. Thus, son denotes a male child. The third is emotive or connotative meaning. The association word produced. So in the praise, don't worry about that. And son, the word son is a term of inder. Is a term of endearment or may in some context be patronizing. Okay, for the formal and dynamic equivalence and the principle of equivalent effect, Nida favors two basic orientation or types of equivalent, namely formal equivalent and dynamic equivalent. The first is formal equivalent. Formal equivalent focus attention on the message itself. It both from the content. One is concerned that the message in the receptor language should match as closely as possible the different elements in the source language. Formal equivalence, later called formal correspondence, is thus keenly oriented toward the structure which we which exert strong influence in determining accuracy and correctness. And the second is dynamic equivalence. Dynamic equivalence, dynamic letters functional equivalent is based on the what Nida calls the principle of equivalence effect, where the relationship between receptor and message should be substantially the same as the same as that which excited between the original receptor and the message. Naturalness is a key requirement for Nida. The success of the translation depends above all on achieving equivalent effect or response. It is one of the four basic requirements of the translation. The first is making sense. The second is conveying the spirit and manner of the original. The third is having a natural and easy form of expression. And the last is producing a similar response. Okay, the third is communicative and semantic translation from Newmark. Communicative and communicative translation attempts to produce on its readers an effect as close as possible to the obtained on the readers of the original. Semantic translation attempts to render as closely as the semantic and synthetic structures of the second language allow. The exact contextual meaning of the original from Newmark, 1981 and 39, this description of communicative translation resembles Nida's dynamic equivalent in the effect it is trying to create on the readers. While semantic translation has similarities to Nida's formal equivalence, however, Newmark distance himself from the full principle of equivalent effect, since the effect is inapparent if the text is out of target language space and time, 1981 and 69. Okay, the last is correspondence and equivalence from color. Correspondence fall within the field of contrastive linguistics, which compress to language system and describes differences and similarities contrastively. equivalent on the other hand relates to equivalent items in specific contexts. Okay, maybe that's all from my explanation. Pardon me please if I'm strict to you. And last I says, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.